Good morning, Bryn Mawr, and to all of those who are sharing in our broadcast this morning. This is your call to worship. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From where do my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your feet slip. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who guards Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. God is your guardian. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not harm you by day, nor the moon at night. God shall protect you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in, now and forevermore.
Greetings, and thank you for worshiping with us. Please join me now as we pray. We thank you, God, for the blessing of gathering again this week, for the opportunity to spend time together in your presence. We are grateful for all that you have done in us, with us, and through us this week. We praise you, and for what you will do in these moments together, we give thanks. So, God, make your presence known to us. Bless our hearts and our spirits with your word. Help us to use this time to draw closer to you and to one another so that we might be on one accord. With anxious anticipation and joy, we pray, and we praise you for what you are going to do here today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we imagine ourselves gathered together in our sanctuary before God, let us now unite our hearts in prayer. God, as people of faith, we come thanking you for the gifts of life and peace of mind. Some might wonder how it is possible to have peace in the midst of chaos. In you, we have learned that peace in any circumstance is not only possible, but consistent with your will for us. And so the ability to be at peace in the storm is truly a blessing. And for that, we thank you. We thank you that life is as good as it is in this moment. It may not be ideal, but daily we are learning and we are witnesses to the reality that our situations could be worse. We thank you for what you provide daily: food, shelter, clothing, and presence and peace of mind. We dare not take any of these things for granted because, God, if nothing else, we are learning that things can change in a moment, and all we have is the moments in which we live. So today we pray that you would continue to speak to us in these days of challenge and help us to know your will and to do your will. We pray that those who are sick and struggling may be more aware of your presence. We pray that we open ourselves to being present with those in need of love, support, or the necessities of life, especially now. We thank you for those who are working so hard to bring our lives back to some sense of normal. Let them know that you are present with them and that those who are part of this beloved community are in their corner. Lord, be our peace, our joy, our support. Give us the ability to share all of these things with those around us. In Christ's name, we continue to pray. Amen.
Our scripture lesson is coming from Matthew chapter 6, verses 5 through 15. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door, and pray to your Father who is in secret. and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. When you are praying, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask him. Pray then in this way. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And do not bring us to the time of trial, but rescue us from the evil one. For if you forgive others their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. And this is the word of the Lord.
For these few moments, let's talk about the need to pray. By now, most of us have become painfully aware of how our lives are changing because of this pandemic. Researchers have known for years how disruptive widespread illnesses are to communities and even countries. The pandemic of 1918 provided a wealth of information about the economic, psychological, social, and religious effects of widespread illnesses upon communities and people. I'll not go into the details of what is known or how we have arrived at the point of repeating and relearning the painful lessons which occurred over a century ago. But I suspect that we're all wondering how we got to this place and what we can learn from those who fought through the Spanish flu pandemic. For those who might be saying, why do we need to know about this? I would remind them of the saying, those who don't know their history are condemned to repeat it. What's particularly important for us today is the reality that life-changing, life-challenging events such as this are taking a significant toll on those who live in these times. We know how this situation is affecting our economy and how it is also forcing us to rethink how we will interact with one another when we are free to move about. People are already talking about how they will change their social habits. Will we shake hands? Will we hug or even have social gatherings the way we did a year ago? Are restaurants and bars no longer going to be places where people can gather with friends? These are just a few of the questions we are already asking ourselves. We're being forced to change our behaviors, and much of the change will not encourage people to be outgoing or engaging. Reclusive persons may be relishing the idea of having to interact less with other people, while more outgoing personalities are struggling because they thrive on seeing smiling faces and responding in kind. This change is forcing us into different living patterns, pushing us to respond differently to the world outside our homes and communities. I would suggest that we need to consider all of this carefully and prayerfully because everyone in the world is being moved to change as a result of this life-altering event. Which prompts me to speak to this issue. How has your prayer life been affected? I suggested a couple of weeks ago that this time of solitude might be an opportunity for us to tune in and to connect more closely with God. For those who didn't quite fully participate in the Lenten ritual of fasting and or giving up something for 40 days, this time can be a chance for you to spend more time becoming better acquainted with the one we claim as the object of our affection. With less distractions, could this be our opportunity to establish or perhaps reestablish a solid, meaningful relationship with God through Jesus Christ? Most of us had no plans to engage in any kind of sacrifice or fast or anything which involved long-term denial beyond Resurrection Sunday. In fact, people were looking forward to more time to enjoy life, to get away from stressful living. But the events of these past couple of months have forced us to face some realities. And for the most part, those changes have not been to our liking. But we could look at these things in a more positive way. For some, it could be a time of engaging in real soul searching. With more time on our hands, maybe we can take more time to learn about what is really going on in our communities and how we as the church can be more a part of the solution in changing our neighborhoods. Certainly, we are all aware of how lost income is affecting many people. This pandemic event could be a spiritual awakening for those who are open to being awakened, or as the young people say, woke. Perhaps this time of solitude is our opportunity to be more open to God's will. That is, if we're willing to take advantage of the opportunity to spend some time with God. Times like this are good times to become better acquainted with God. The media is overwhelming us with bad news, so perhaps it's time to seek out the good. Prayer time is our time to become energized and tuned up like athletes preparing for a new season. We can use this time to get ourselves ready for the next phase of our journey. Instead of soaking up all the bad news and worrying about what's next, perhaps we can make this our prayer training time. Take some time to become enriched through prayer. Prayer is vital to our understanding of our relationship with God. I've said it before that prayer is an opportunity to listen to God and to talk to God. It's time during which we spend meditating and contemplating God's presence. Prayer time is space where we can open ourselves to hearing God speak to us and sharing with God what's on our hearts and minds. If we're not using some of this time to get closer to God, we stand to miss out on what God needs and desires the most from us: our commitment to a real relationship. Prayer can help us find our bearings and get on the right path. This truly is our time to reacquaint ourselves with God. For most of us, the practice of praying is probably not real easy, especially now because we're more worried about things like our health, our livelihoods, and yes, whether we're ever going to get back to our church home. It's hard to think about spending quiet time with God because we have in our minds that there are more important things that we must do to survive, and certainly God understands that. These are real issues which need our attention, but could it be possible that God will provide the answers to our problems in the time that we spend talking with and listening to God, or just spending a few moments in quiet meditation and reflection on the Word of God? So let me offer a suggestion. God would welcome the chance to have your undivided attention, just a few moments at a time. This time is a good time to schedule some time for God, to spend some time in sacred silence, listening for what God has been trying to tell you. But remember, prayer is two-way communication. So when you talk to God and you listen to God, end your time by reciting the Lord's Prayer. But don't just speak the words. Think about what you are saying. As you become more comfortable in your time with God, increase that time. Make it your business to make this time the most special time of your day, because guess what? You're truly committing yourself to spending time in the presence of God. In our scripture lesson, Jesus presented to his followers something they had probably not experienced previously, an opportunity to become intimate, close to God. Jesus was encouraging people to make space for God so that they might understand how much God loved them. As a Jew, he understood the teachings of the temple, which encouraged prayer three times a day with a prescribed way in which they should pray. They were even given the words to say. But at some point, like we realize, the words become meaningless. They just are another routine that we go through. Jesus knew that in order for people to become more intimately involved with God, they needed to spend some real time talking with God, being comfortable speaking about the issues of their hearts. Prayer is more than repeating words we learn. Prayer should be a real heart-to-heart talk with God. It should be our time to say whatever's on our hearts without trying to fashion fancy words or repeat worn-out phrases. In order to be more comfortable with God, we need to be honest with God, and we need to be prepared to allow God to be honest with us. That's how great relationships are born and how they succeed. They begin with honest talk between parties who care about one another. Jesus also taught that prayer is not a time for showcasing one's religion. Note what he says in our scripture lesson. Do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the street corners to be seen by men. I tell you the truth, they have received their reward in full. But when you pray, go into your room, close the door, and pray to your Father who is unseen. In other words, genuine prayer is not a time to flaunt your religion, but rather it is a time to spend relating to God. Even in our prayers as a community, we should be focused on what we want to share with God, not how we're saying it. Prayer is our chance to hear what God is saying to us, as well as us spending time telling God about us. When we pray, we should be aware that our spirits are making contact with the Holy Spirit, and that God is really listening. True prayer moves us to engage with God. If we are genuinely desirous of having a relationship with God, then we must make our time with God quality time. Even a few minutes of alone time with God, making God the center of our lives, can make a huge difference in our approaches to life. Jesus also reminds us that prayer is a time in which we connect with God by sharing with God all of the things about us, the good stuff and the things that we really don't want to share with God. Prayer time should remind us that we are dependent upon God to help us to do better and to be better. During our prayer time, we need to be honest with ourselves and with God, whom we can trust with our deepest secrets. It is through the practice of prayer, spending time with God, that we can become better. Through prayer, we begin to understand God's will for our lives. And the more we pray, the more we will understand why God has placed us where we are in life. Through prayer, we become anxious to please God, to live in God's will, and to carry out God's will in our daily living. Jesus reminds us to spend real time talking in real ways to God. Fancy words, they're not necessary. So be genuine. Keep it real. God understands. Most importantly, know that you are talking with somebody who really, really cares about you more, perhaps, than you will ever know. No one is more important to God than you when you are praying. God listens without judgment and is faithful to provide an answer to your prayers. So focus on the fact that you are spending time with the one who cares for you more than you may ever, ever know. Time spent with God is time well spent. So I encourage you to use these days to get in touch with God and to remember that you are not alone, because God is with you. Amen. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for giving us the privilege of prayer and for reminding us of the importance of spending time with you. Help us to recognize how spending more time in your presence can help us recognize and understand your will for our lives and how we can be what you have made us to be. Keep reminding us that you are always wanting what is best for us. Move us to make time to spend in your holy presence daily. Through Christ our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. And now receive the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May God cause his face to shine upon you and grant you in these days to come his love, his peace, and his joy. Amen.